too.
Do me a favor. Look around you. Look to your left, to your right, behind you, in front of you. What do you see? You see fonts. They're everywhere, on buildings, cars, in restaurants, and on your favorite soda pop can. But what is their history? How do brands use them? And why do we read some better than others?
I know I'd go from rags to riches.
It all started way back in 1440. The first typeface was a black letter variety used by Johannes Gutenberg on the first printing press. The font was meant to mimic the calligraphic handwriting used by monks to hand transcribe manuscripts prior to the invention of the printing press. In 1734, William Castellan created a new typeface style that included more contrast between strokes in each letter form. Now referred to as Old Style, these typefaces made letter forms more distinguishable from one another, improving readability. Then in 1816, the first sans-serif typeface became commercially available after having been developed by William Castellan IV. It caught on quickly, and advertisements and other printed material from the early 19th century stood out because of its use. Fast forward to 1954. This was the year that the world of fonts, and perhaps Earth itself, changed forever. A name that sounded so sweet, so seductive. Synonymous with wealth, style, power. The little black dress of typography, Helvetica. The most used font of the past 70 years, Helvetica was created in Switzerland by freelance designer Max Alphonse Meidinger. His aim was to create a sans-serif font with a linear, simple, and elegant design.
Helvetica, it has over 500 different type of variations. It is a font that initially got designed so that humans were able to read it.
And read it they shall, because in 1984, a man by the name of Steve Jobs decided to include the font on a new computer he designed, the Macintosh. Since then, you'll find Helvetica everywhere and not even know it. On advertisements, street signs, car companies, office supply stores, everywhere. But this raises an interesting question. If Helvetica is everywhere and you don't even know it, what other fonts are hiding right underneath your nose? And how do they support brand recognition? Whether it be for a company's logo, a car advertisement, or a movie's poster, fonts are often unexpectedly recognizable in association with whatever source has used them. This is because fonts convey the values and the tone of a brand just as much as colors and imagery does. They are a large part of its visual identity and will almost always have a profound influence on the audience. But above all, brands strive for artistic recognition, because sometimes familiarity is what separates one logo, advertisement, or movie poster from the other.
So when we're building a brand, we're picking the right costume and the right typography for that particular brand. So we're studying intensively and deeply what is the brand for, what is the goal, what is the vision, the mission for that particular company.
A memorable typeface is instantly recognizable. Let's put this to the test, shall we? Where have you seen this font before? Looks familiar, doesn't it? What about this one? Well, this one. A part of your brain probably recognizes where you've seen them before based solely on the font, but not all film productions get as creative with their font choice.
I forgot about it for years, but then I remembered that Avatar, a giant international blockbuster, used the papyrus font as its logo.
He just highlighted Avatar, he clicked the drop-down menu, and then he just randomly selected papyrus.
I don't even think this is literally papyrus. Maybe that was the starting point, but they clearly modified this.
But whatever they did, it wasn't enough!
I think about it every time I see papyrus.
Okay, where else do you even see this font?
Hookah bars, Shakira merch,
off-brand tees.
But not every brand looks to be recognized through their font. Sometimes their biggest concern is readability.
The type of typography that you often see on a book or even in certain logos, they are completely, a majority of them, they are going to be humanist fonts, meaning it's fonts that are supposed to be read. The fonts and typography like Comic Sans are not supposed to be fonts specifically used for those type of approaches.
Because not every font is meant to dazzle, is it? Not every typeface has to entice the viewer with flashy serifs and unique color. If nothing else, fonts are a visual language, and since the world has shifted so much of its systems and industries onto an online forum, font readability and accessibility have been more important than ever. Scholars have even attempted to track the psychological connection between fonts and their readability. Studies show that Verdana and Times New Roman are often at the top of typeface preference, fonts you've probably heard of and are examples of humanist fonts, which are a group of typefaces characterized by their legibility. But while the world of fonts can and should be analyzed from every perspective, they can also be stripped away of all their pleasantries and all of their complications. Because of the hundreds of thousands of fonts that there are, whether they're for the credits of a movie or a paper for a class, every word scattered across whatever canvas is in front of you is simply a small combination of the same 26 letters. From A to Z.